So I'm just going to start you off now. You are all very welcome to the Chester Beatty's live harp recital with Aisling Ennis. And it is in collaboration with the National Concert Hall. My name is Heidi, and myself and my colleague Justina will be in the background if you need any assistance. Aisling has very kindly agreed to take questions at the end of the performance. So if you have anything you'd like to ask her, please pop those into the Q&A and we'll love to hear from you. So without further delay, please sit back with a nice glass of something and some nibbles while I pass you over to Aisling, and we hope you enjoy the performance. Aisling.
Thanks a million for having me. I'm really excited to be here in my sitting room with all of you. I am picturing you all hopefully tucked up nice and cosy and comfortable, maybe with a hot drink. It's a bit kind of miserable and rainy outside where I am, so I was sort of relieved not to have to cart this big harp out this evening. I have a programme of sort of really festive sweets, like a bag of sweets for you, and I hope it warms you on this winter evening. I'm going to start, I actually had thought I'll put one or two of the movements from Marcel Tournier's Six Noels, and they're all so charming, most of them have sort of crept in. So I'm going to start with this piece. For me, it's just incredibly evocative of this wintry time. It evokes a lot of images for me around winter and snuggling up and snowy scenes and winter kind of snow-laden villages and all sorts. So it's definitely a festive favourite of mine. And it, to accompany it or to introduce it, I am going to read for you a poem called Winter Eyes, and this is by Douglas Florian. And for me, maybe it just sets the mood, sets the tone for this recital that we have together. And I hope it finds you well. Winter Eyes. Look at winter with winter eyes, as smoke curls from rooftops to clear cobalt skies. Breathe in winter. Past winter knows the sweet scent of black birch where velvet moss grows. Walk through winter with winter feet on crackling ice or sloshy wet sleet. Listen to winter with winter ears, the rustling of oak leaves as spring slowly nears. that is five of the six of Marcel Tournier's Six Noels. A beautiful piece that was composed in 1926. And Tournier is responsible for so many incredible pieces of music for the harp. He was the professor of harp in the Paris Conservatoire from 1912 right up until 1948. And his wife, Renee, actually was the professor of the chromatic harp, because of course, at in the earlier part of the 20th century, there was a bit of a race to the moon happening in a way in the harp world. This is a double action pedal harp, and this was first sort of invented in the early 1800s, but it took a bit of time to get it just right, because in order to make all the various notes of all the various keys and scales, I have seven pedals here. So there are actually 2,000 moving parts within the mechanism of this wonderful harp. And at the beginning of the 20th century, the chromatic harp, which was an instrument that had two rows of strings, this being maybe the white notes on the piano and this being the black notes, Pleyel commissioned Debussy to write his dances, a stunning piece of chamber music that we harpists are now gifted with, thanks to that. So that was composed in 1904. And then in 1905, Erard commissioned Ravel, and none other than Ravel, to compose his stunning introduction and allegro. So we now have these two incredible pieces. And Marcel Tournier, of course, would have been friendly with the likes of Debussy and Ravel. And the next piece that I'm going to play is Etude de Concert au Matin. So this is a piece that actually he wrote, it's an earlier piece than his Six Noels. And this piece is, it's like a homage to sunrise. He says, you know, you can imagine the chattering of the birds and just the joy and the cheek and the fun and just, I guess, the vibrance of a sunrise. And it's an incredibly beautiful piece. I have found another a short poem that I thought was quite pretty. And I'm going to team it with this next piece, Au Matin, by Marcel Tournier. And this is called Nothing Gold Can Stay, from Robert Frost. Nature's first green is gold, her hardest hue to hold. Her early leaf's a flower, but only so an hour. Then leaf subsides to leaf, so Eden sank to grief. So dawn goes down to day, nothing gold can stay. Thank you. Bit of Tournier to start us off. Hope you're all doing okay there. You're very well behaved, very quiet and well behaved audience. Handy that mute button. So I'm going to move on now to an incredibly special piece of music at this time of year, and in ordinary circumstances there would be performances, many performances of this happening at this time of year. So the next piece is going to be the interlude from Britain's Ceremony of Carols. This piece is just so incredible in so many ways. Britain composed this on his way back from America in 1942 on what must have been a pretty nerve-wracking transatlantic boat trip. I can't think of many things worse than traveling from America across the Atlantic Ocean in 1942, international waters, but that's what he did. And whilst on that journey, he composed Ceremony of Carols. And actually, in a stop off in Nova Scotia, he came across a book of poetry, mainly in Middle English, and this was to become his Ceremony of Carols. Actually, he added the interlude, which is the seventh movement, this harp solo, from his Ceremony of Carols. He added it a little bit later. It was a turning point for Britain in the sense that his writing, his compositions were perhaps more angular and less maybe melodic than the likes of Bach's or Vaughan Williams. And it meant that he really didn't get the same sort of seat at the table as they did at the time. But because he composed this for a treble, three-part treble chorus and harp, it was originally performed by a boys' chorus. And perhaps for that reason, some of the melodies are more melodic and maybe simpler. But it marked a shift, you know, in his writing, maybe back to his English roots, and maybe more populist writing a little bit. But this magical movement from his Ceremony of Carols is just a delight to play. There are lots of harmonics, which is a technique on the harp, a very sparkling sound created. And it, I have some of the text from another movement that I'm going to read to you, if you like. And this is from the movement that follows the interlude in Freezing Winter. This is actually taken from a poem, a piece of verse by Robert Southwell, who was an Elizabethan Catholic priest, and he lived towards the end of the 16th century. So, behold a silly tender babe in freezing winter night, in homely manger trembling lies, alas, a piteous sight. The inns are full, no man will yield this little pilgrim bed, but forced he is with silly beasts in crib to shroud his head. This stable is a prince's court, this crib his chair of state, the beasts are parcel of his pump, the wooden dish his plate. The persons in that poor attire his royal liveries wear, the prince himself is come from heaven, this pomp is prized there. With joy approach, O Christian rite, do homage to thy king, and highly praise his humble pomp, which he from heaven doth bring. Thank you. the interlude from Britain's A Ceremony of Carols. Now for a change of tack, I popped in a caroling set because it feels a bit rude to be giving a winter festive recital and not throw in even the smallest bit of caroling. So I'm going to play two pieces, two of probably his best known, much loved pieces of music. The first is Eleanor Plunkett and the second is Fanny Parr. For those of you who don't know, Turlough O'Carolan was one of the most famous harpists of his time. In the early 1700s, he would have made his living travelling around the country composing planxtes, or a piece of music, for the aristocrats of the time. So if you gave him bed and board and he had a nice meal and a nice stay, you might get a nice tune from him. So we have hundreds of gorgeous tunes by Carolan. Eleanor Plunkett is a beautiful air, and Fanny Parr. Hope you enjoy. Okay, I can see some little chats coming up, so I'll definitely look forward to having a look at those maybe towards the end. This next piece of music first appeared on our screens in 1939 when a very young Judy Garland sang it towards the beginning of The Wizard of Oz. And of course, it went on to win the Academy Award for the Best Original Song in 1939 and Judy Garland's signature song. It is, of course, Over the Rainbow. And this arrangement that I'm playing today is by Skyla Kanga, who is a very eminent harpist based in London. And she has a lovely book of arrangements of some beautiful standards, including this one. It'll be when all the musicals are on this time of year. I keep looking at my laptop, but of course you guys are up there on my webcam. So we're motoring along nicely, as one might say. This next piece of music isn't in the programme that was on the website. I was very bold and I sort of changed things around a bit, as I'm known to do. This next piece is called Moat Sir, and it's a traditional song that would be sung during Hanukkah when the festival lights have been lit, because of course Hanukkah starts tomorrow. So a very happy Hanukkah to Jewish friends, and I hope you enjoy this harp version. It's not a song that I was familiar with, but luckily I was able to ask a friend in the know, and they highly recommended this. So this is my arrangement, or a noodling on Moatzer. And actually I have some of the an English translation from the Hebrew for it. If you would like, I can recite it to you now before I play. Kindling new the holy lamps, priests approved in suffering. Purify the nation's shrine, brought to God their offering. And his court surrounding, here in joy abounding, happy throngs singing songs with a mighty sounding. Happy throngs singing songs with a mighty sounding. This short recital. I hope you're all doing okay and you still have some hot chocolate or tea or coffee or whatever you have in your cup, and that you're still nice and comfy. I couldn't really finish up without playing this next piece. I love this one. It's The Dirty Laundry Rag, if you believe that, and it's by a fella called Park Stickney, who is an incredible harpist and musician, American harpist, studied in Juilliard and really turned the harp into his own instrument entirely, and has really expanded how we interpret and how we perform and play and arrange and transcribe jazz onto the harp. So this is his composition, The Dirty Laundry Rag. And I have to confess that actually I had this sheet music for quite a while, and it's very tricky, and I think I sort of avoided it for a long time for that reason, but it's great fun, and I hope it puts a smile on your face on these dark sort of wintry nights and what has been certainly a tricky year. But this is The Dirty Laundry Rag by Park Stickney, and if you really want to see smoke coming from a harpist and from a harp, I highly recommend that you look up him performing this, because there really is nothing quite like Park Stickney performing this. But here we go. I'm going to give it a shot, and then maybe I'll have a little look at some of the comments, or we can have some questions, or over to you guys then. There might be one up the sleeve for afterwards.
Thank you.
going to have a little look at the comments now. I better put my ears back in, hadn't I? I can't hear anything. You could be saying anything at all, Heidi. I wouldn't know.
We were not talking about you in any bad way whatsoever, because I wait till you hear some of this. Some of the comments we have had coming in is just so lovely. First, I think we should address that you have had a big hello from your Thursday group. Loads of them are here and absolutely delighted. They're all so thrilled with you. They want you to keep doing poetry, by the way, for your Thursday.
You're gonna rod from my back there, haven't I?
Exactly. We have greetings from Germany. These songs remind me of my childhood. They're just like Christmas. Congratulations. The poetry between each music is so beautiful. Aisling has opened my eyes to the beauty of the harp, and I'm a brass player. And then we have, from Nathan, would like to know, are there any words or poems that go with the Dirty Laundry song? He's smiling away and he wishes you a happy Christmas.
Oh, thanks a million, Nathan. Look, Park Stickney Up, he is fabulous. He really, really is. He's got a number of really brilliant albums, Overdressed Late Guy and I think Double Action Harp is another one. He's got 4 or 5 brilliant albums, and he plays some insane solos from jazz standards on the harp. I mean, it's diabolical what he's able to do on the harp. I'm not sure about words for the Dirty Laundry Rag. Maybe you could write them, Nathan, and I'm sure if you sent them to Park, he'd get a real kick out of it. He's a brilliant guy. He'd love that if somebody came up with some lyrics, if he hasn't already, and sent them along to him, because he's a really fun guy.
That's great, Aisling. Thank you. That's actually the last of our questions, but I'm afraid they don't want you to go, because the amount of comments is just, this is fantastic, this is beautiful, we're having fun playing along with the ragtime. Do you have a CD available?
I have CDs with other groups that I've performed with. A CD might be something that I look at in the new year. I suppose, again, I was always busy gigging, and I have been lucky to be involved in a lot of other people's CDs, which is very lovely. And with a group I perform with, Affinity, we would have a number of CDs out. And we have a little joke. We say there's no I in team, but there are 3 I's in Affinity, because we spell it Affinity. So if you were to look up Affinity, you will find 3 albums with them, and there are some kind of instrumentals on those. But part of this strange, challenging year has been suddenly having the space and the time to reflect, I suppose, on the work that I had been doing, and maybe what the work that I might like to do, or so there might be a CD next year. We'll see. We'll play it by ear.
Very exciting. And that's about it. So plenty more, please do some mores coming in. So do you have a sneaky something for us?
I do have a sneaky something. I have it up on the stand here. This is another one of Skyla Kanga's arrangements. It'll start off as Skyla Kanga's arrangement, but then I'll probably morph into noodling. I love sort of improvising and noodling around things, so I can be quite bold. I was very good, and I played most of those according to how they should have been played. But this is Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. I think there's just something incredibly warm and sentimental and well-wishing about this piece. And I'm so delighted that you've enjoyed this recital. I hope it finds you well. I hope, despite this odd year, that perhaps opportunities like this and occasions like this have showed you things you might not otherwise have experienced. I think in strange ways, although our worlds have gotten very small and closed, it has sort of opened up in other ways as well. So thank you. Thank you for joining. Thank you for staying. A huge thank you again to Heidi and to everybody in the Chester Beatty and the National Concert Hall for giving this little musician a chance to share some music with you. I'm going to button my lips now, and I'm going to play Skyla Kanga's Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, and we'll see what happens. I'm going to take these off. It's not how I'm not even going to pretend that's how it starts. I'm in the wrong key. That's what happened. I was having a little bit of a moment there. I was just in the wrong key. I'm very sorry, everybody. I promise I'll do it correctly this time. Neither of those were Skyla Kanga's arrangements. Skyla Kanga, if you're watching, she's just going, this girl just isn't. She's not playing my arrangement at all. This is Skyla Kanga's arrangement.
Thank you.
That was actually like one of my favorites, and from my favorite film too. Oh, Aisling, this evening has just been so wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, we hope you all enjoyed this evening's performance. Just a reminder that we have plenty more events and activities coming up. So please go to our website, chesterbeatty.ie, and go to What's On. You can check out what we have coming up for the rest of December and for January. If you haven't already signed up to our mailing list, please make sure you do that while you're there, and so you don't miss out on any activities. And as I mentioned earlier, if you could take a few moments to donate, we would really appreciate that. The support link is on the homepage, and perhaps you can consider giving the gift of a membership to the Chester Beatty as a gift this year. So thank you all for joining us. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, and we hope to see you all again very, very soon. Bye-bye.